and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we'll take a look at how to write custom aggregates in Postgres using either Rust or raw SQL. We'll start with this article by Anna, which describes how to use the new PGX release to write a Rust extension for Postgres that runs custom aggregate code. The way to think about aggregates in Postgres, they're essentially functions that take input values and then combine that into a resulting value. For example, a sum of integers or a JSON aggregate function, which can take individual rows and aggregates them into one resulting JSON object. Conceptually, this also exists in other languages. In Rust itself, there are iterators, and those iterators can also help you collect the data into a particular data type to summarize that data. The way that aggregates work in Postgres is actually pretty straightforward. Surprisingly, a lot of people don't know about this. It shows the power of Postgres and how it allows you to customize each aspect of the database, similar to how it supports custom data types. This is the simplest version of a sum function using raw SQL. First, creating a function that gets executed each time the state needs to be updated. In this case, we're just adding the value itself to the input value. Then we take the last state as the result. You can run this yourself, pretty simple. This is similar to how you would write this in Rust. You have a variable, and then inside the loop, you keep adding to a variable, then you return the value of that variable. Postgres can do more things than just that, though. There's also a way to write custom combined functions that let you handle partial aggregates, which then let you use parallel processing in Postgres. The last thing to mention here on aggregates is final functions. Instead of taking the last state value as the result, they let you transform that state that was accumulated over time into a particular value. For example, sum up all the text values in a state, and at the end, count the number of distinct values. Now, this is pretty cool. What's new here is that the PGX mechanism to write extensions in Postgres now has support for writing your own custom aggregate functions in Rust. With PGX, you can now write Rust code to create your custom aggregates in Postgres. It's pretty self-explanatory to follow this along. The simplest example here of an aggregate function, this is the state that keeps track of what gets aggregated. And then we also have the state function that gets called for each input value. A lot of the work here is being done for you. Within 20 lines of Rust code, you got your first aggregate. Really fast, really easy to use. You may also be interested to look at ordered set aggregates. Here's an example implementation of percentiles. There is an existing function in Postgres that does this, but it's a great example of how flexible this API is and what you can now do in Rust. This is a new release for PGX that I would encourage you to take a look at. In her article, Anna also referenced two other posts, which I think are nice overviews of how to use aggregates. For example, Tim, a couple of years back, had described how to use raw SQL to implement the harmonic mean and geometric mean in Postgres. Specifically, coming from this Python code to run that type of logic, what he wanted to do is move that into the database. How can we run this type of code on database side using custom aggregates? Pretty simple, same create aggregate, and then using raw SQL functions to implement these geometric means and harmonic means. What's nice about it is that you can simplify your queries instead of having things like this inline, much easier to read, in some cases can be optimized better by Postgres. Last but not least, this is, I would say, more advanced. Although if you're writing aggregates in Rust, you're probably at a level where you know a lot. What TimescaleDB wrote about last year, how they used aggregation in Postgres to refine their hyperfunctions design. That state function and those finalize functions, they usually are hidden for you behind the scenes. Postgres does that, and you don't really interact with the details of the aggregate API. What TimescaleDB has done here is that they have extracted that into an explicit design pattern. Maybe a way to think about this is map and reduce. The idea is that you can have a function that simplifies your data into a certain form that is easier to work with, that you can then get a result for. The reason that they separated this, one of the motivations is they're actually able to optimize things better in Postgres. For example, you run this separately, you have each element in the target list calculate its own percentile and doing its own aggregation. Versus if you have this two-step process exposed explicitly, then you can tell Postgres that you can reuse that. Here they have this in between percentile aggregation logic, and then out of that logic, they extract the approximate percentiles with P10, P15, P90 here. They also describe later on how they utilize this to calculate things over time. Sometimes you want to keep accumulating something, but you don't want to accumulate the full raw data set because it's pretty expensive. With their implementation of continuous aggregates using, you know, the same Postgres aggregation API, it's possible to keep a smaller data set over time. If you want to learn more about aggregates, these are really great things to check out. If you want to use, you know, Rust and Postgres, then PGX is a great way to do that. Thank you so much and see you next week.